You missed that little adjective.
Still mad at my mom for making her return it.
The tip is underway between the Lynx and the Sky. Olympic team as well as Allie Quigley with the ball right now, trying to get healthy as well, and she picks up where she left off, but that's a long two. When I say Sloot got off to a slow start, how about this stat against Dallas in their last game? She was held without an assist for the first 16 and a half minutes of that game. We've got an and one back the other way. Nafisa Collier will have a free throw coming up. 4-2 advantage, Chicago over Minnesota right now. The Sky took that first meeting on June 15th as Sloot gets the finger roll finish. Which I don't know why you would want to miss.
I don't know why you would either.
First 3 minutes of our telecast. Allie Quigley for three. She hit seven of those against Dallas in the last game.
With so much confidence right now.
Two players have scored for Chicago. Allie Quigley with five and Courtney Vandersloot with four as Sylvia Fowles backs down for the bucket, her first of the game. Fowles comes up to set the screen on Clarendon, who takes it inside, goes high off the glass. She was looking for more and didn't get the call.
Sylvia Fowles, something in the water, man. She just plays really well in Chicago.
She's drinking the tap water in Chicago. Pump fake. Collier's got another and one. She drew the foul against Diamond DeShield.
You're starting to sound like Oprah. You get a foul and you get a foul. Everyone's getting fouls today.
No, except when Oprah does it, you want to get what Oprah's dishing out on the transition. 3 3-point attempts here for Chicago. Two of those three coming from Allie Quigley as Clarendon takes it left side for two.
Vandersloot bodied up into Clarendon early on in that possession, but you just saw a look of determination in Clarendon's eyes to get to the bucket and score.
Sloot to Seth Dolson, nicely done, and the lead is cut to one.
Early on, Minnesota is switching those ball screens, and there has been some height advantages.
Dolson, the first player not named Courtney Vandersloot or Allie Quigley to score, and Clarendon is hot in this first quarter. 7 points now for Leisha Clarendon. First time she has come off the bench this year. She started all 22 coming into this game as Sloot gets another finger roll to tie it at 17. This is set to check in for the Sky. Clarendon with those 7 points here in this first quarter, make it 9 points. And again, she's looking for some calls. Fouls and one.
Yeah, sometimes indefinitely doesn't have a definite ending, so good to know there does sometimes.
Oh, it's indefinitely behind the back. Diamond DeShields. Golden on that move.
How about fancy behind the back, a little woof. That was fun to watch.
It was worth a woof. Oh, but they might be loud enough that, you know, Chicagoland could hear them. Diamond DeShields with the block. And Dana Evans on the push. Finds Copper for two. Sanwa returned on August 15th against New York after missing 10 games with an MCL injury. And Chicago picking up another bucket to cut the lead to four in the final few seconds. Lynx trying to get one more, and Dangerfield brings it up with 0.6 left. Well, Candace Parker got locked up with Kayla Thornton. She didn't even have the ball on the baseline as Allie turns and fires.
Into the spot, beating Collier to the spot to get the position for the block.
Woo! Fouls, the quick turnaround, and she's got a quick two.
The quick footwork from Foul is able to beat her defender to the spot and make that an easy layup.
She's got 7 points and 9 minutes of play. They're looking for her. Here's Quigley. Now for Allie. Here's Clarendon. A good first half for Leisha Clarendon. Picked up a ton of fouls here in this first half. Backdoor look, Clarendon still has not missed. A perfect 7 for 7.
Clarendon's moving so well without the ball. Makes that hard cut, and Chicago gets caught ball watching.
And that was probably the toughest shot that Clarendon has had to hit. Fouls, tough pass for her to handle. Lynx stay with it, they give it right back to her. Good decision.
To keep that guide hand up to try to protect any sort of block from coming over. Look at Vandersloot getting the and one to go.
Courtney Vandersloot left all alone. Time to take a triple and hit the three. 27 of the 40 combined between them, and Sloot with the pick. Steal off to the races for two. It's a 6-point game. Courtney Vandersloot again. She's got 5 points. points. She's got the last 7 points for Chicago. Get a bye. The top two get that double bye. And it's the top eight that make the playoffs as Clarendon gets another bucket. Vandersloot kicks it over to Copper. Crossover move and the finish with the left hand.
Time getting to the basket.
Now Clarendon misread that with Sylvia Fowles, and Stevens picks it up for basically a warm-up layup. To begin with, starting Azaree Stevens on Tuesday against Dallas with a Candace Parker. And
wow.
Reverse and backdoor look, and quickly gets the finish.
Quickly with the counter move, backdoor cut to the basket.
Dantas feeding foul. Look how deep she got.
Game to stay within the coaching box. Most coaches don't usually stay inside of it. Copper, my goodness, getting to the basket with ease. They need her to continue doing that.
And Copper nowhere to go. Good defense that time for Minnesota.
The help came over too, not allowing Copper to have an extra angle to the basket.
Dantas for three. Dolson has only missed that one free throw all season, by the way. Backdoor look to Dantas. The two rebounds surprises me a little bit. Good bounce pass, and Dufall with the finish.
Dufall did a nice job denying and getting a hand on that ball.
Deep two attempts, and Sloot drills it.
In the league, like we were just talking about during the break, always finds a way to make it work, like Azaree Stevens finding a way to make it work.
It'll be interesting to see with those 35 points sitting on the bench. Maybe it's Diamond DeShields time. Or Kalia Copper time. Here's your answer. I think Mike Thibault and company is excited
yes.
to watch her play.
I think I made the most obvious statement in the world. Just
Dangerfield getting the screen from Fowles. A little in and out dribble move, and Dangerfield has another bucket. Copper. Cutting it inside for two. Try to stop that. That was the first Chicago lead, by the way, since midway through the first quarter. McBride with the backdoor and finish. Ariel Powers back playing for the Lynx. After that thumb surgery, she'll take the high arcing shot. Shovel pass to Chanwa. No. Chanwa kicking it out to Dangerfield, who kicks it off for two.
Both of these teams have made each other pay for any sort of mistake. Not a ton of turnovers necessarily, but Minnesota has 19 points.
That's the point of the story.
Efficiency. They've made each other pay for mistakes.
Steph Dolson making the Minnesota defense pay on that possession. It's been a little bit of the substitution pattern for James Wade here tonight, and Dolson has a quick 5 points. Not exactly the way they drew it up. Is that what you're saying?
You know what? Take the words right out of my mouth.
Collier, out 17-footer. Dantas with eight. Double-figure scores and Fowles, McBride, and Clarendon tonight. And Quigley. And Minnesota playing with its subs other than Collier. Here to begin the fourth quarter, Ariel Powers looks smooth. Pull off for Vandersloot. Easy lay-in for two. Carlton gets it.
What makes her such an elite shooter?
Oh, a three for a three. Dangerfield with the answer that time.
Fowles did a good job coming over to help that time.
Pull up for Collier. Maybe we're in the Windy City. Maybe there was a gust of wind that came through. Quigley knocks down the three. That was a good chunk of the first half where she hadn't even missed a shot. She was 7-for-7 to begin. Courtney Vandersloot drills the three-point shot.
Again, this Lynx team has been so good managing the clock at the end of this game.
Fowles, one triple pull-up. And in for the layup, and James Wade is forced to call the timeout. And there's your final, 101-95.